What goes up must come down, or splashdown in this case. The SpaceX Dragon space capsule landed in the Pacific Ocean Tuesday morning.
These big chutes are orange, are 116 feet across, and it slows it down to only 12 miles per hour. So they hit the water at 12 miles per hour, and the ships are going to get it now.
Wow, it just happened, yeah?
Yeah, it just happened, 12:34 Eastern time.
After 3 weeks attached to the International Space Station, the SpaceX Dragon cargo ship was released Tuesday and began its five-hour descent back to Earth.
The team at SpaceX reporting that the burn was conducted as expected, everything on Dragon on board is looking good.
NASA says the Dragon carried supplies and vital science experiments. With that description, about the last thing you would expect the spacecraft to hold is Legos. But sure enough, NBC reports the Dragon brought back to Earth 13 sets of Lego toy blocks that were flown up to the station 2 years ago aboard the shuttle Endeavour. Apparently, astronauts used the Lego models in educational videos to show how machines work and weightlessness. The mission to the station and back cost a hefty $150 million. The splashdown marks the end of the second successful SpaceX flight commissioned by NASA to supply the space station. Fox News reports this landing could be among the last of its kind.
The plan is to have the Dragon capsule leave the space station, descend down to Earth, and then drop and land safely on a landing zone on ground, eliminating the need and cost of an ocean retrieval.
Earlier this month, SpaceX proved that was possible. It launched a rocket that hovered 24 stories high for half a minute before landing safely back on ground. The change is part of SpaceX's attempts to make spaceflight cheaper through reusability, all so that the Dragon can fulfill its intended use to transport humans. A blogger writes, the idea behind SpaceX is to eventually enable private human space travel, and the Dragon's safe return is another key milestone for the company. He adds the fact that SpaceX founder Elon Musk has been able to raise capital for such an aggressive and improbable business is quite impressive. Musk hopes to have people inside the Dragon as it races into outer space by 2015. The U.S. lost the ability to send humans to space when it retired the space shuttle fleet in 2011. For Newsy, I'm Lauren Gorris.